It's AumSum time.
Hi guys. Can you guess the title of my next video? Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
What is a migraine?
A bad headache.
Nah. Hmm? A migraine is not just a bad headache. It is often accompanied by other symptoms like vomiting, nausea, sensitivity to light, sound, etc. Hence, migraine is actually a multi-symptom disorder. Migraine headaches can last from 4 hours to 72 hours. However, the duration and symptoms may vary from person to person. Usually, the symptoms like food cravings, neck stiffness, yawning, constipation, etc. may begin before the actual headache. This period is called prodrome phase. After this, the phase called aura begins, in which an individual may experience blurred vision, slurred speech, pins and needle sensations, etc. Then begins the attack phase when actual headache strikes. The pain is often only on one side of the head and is accompanied by symptoms like nausea, vomiting, etc. After the attack phase, when the headache subsides, the individual may experience confusion, fatigue, etc. This phase is called postdrome phase. Topic: bad breath. Why do we get bad breath? Huh?
It's not bad breath, it's perfume.
Oh, gross. Bad breath is generally caused by bacteria that live in our mouth. These bacteria feed on the food particles which get stuck in our teeth, gums, and tongue. They break down the food particles into simpler forms, releasing foul-smelling compounds such as hydrogen sulfide, methane thiol, and cadaverine. These gases form the bad breath.
But why is morning breath so bad?
Usually during the day, saliva carries the food particles and bacteria from the mouth into our stomach, thus controlling the bad breath. However, when we sleep, we produce less saliva, making our mouth dry. This increases the growth of bacteria, thus increasing the breakdown of food and producing bad breath in the morning. Topic: comets. Why do comets have tails?
Maybe because, like monkeys, they can hang themselves on trees.
Nah, let me explain. A comet is a mixture of rocks, dust, and ice. This ice is basically frozen water and frozen gases. When a comet approaches the sun, it starts to heat up, converting ice directly into gas and releasing the trapped dust particles in space.
So, you mean a comet has two tails?
Absolutely.
Oh, stop bluffing.
No, it is true. The ultraviolet radiations from the sun ionize the gas, and the solar wind carries this ionized gas away from the sun, forming an ion tail. Whereas, the light from the sun exerts pressure on the dust particles and pushes them away, creating a dust tail.